And now for something completely different.
That must be the first architect now. Ah, yes, it's Mr. Wiggin of Ironside and Malone. I'm sorry about that, gentlemen. The second architect is Mr. Levy of Wymus and Dibble. Oh.
Good morning, gentlemen.
A nude lady with a fully comprehensive motor insurance. If you just want third parties, she has to keep her bra on. And if it's just theft, then
no,
it's...
No, I don't really want that.
Devious.
Mr. Devious.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
The Reverend.
The Reverend who?
The Reverend Morrison.
Oh, come in.
Excuse me, do I have any more lines?
I don't know, Mush. I'll have a look in your script. Where are we? Show 8. Are you man?
Yeah, man.
No, you finished?
Well, I'll be off then.
Right.
Okay, Devious, don't move.
The Bishop!
Therefore, I name this child.
Don't say the kid's name, Vic!
Francesco Luigi.
We was too late. The Reverend Nuke saw the light.
The splendor falls on castle walls, and snowy summits bold and
sorry. Here, there's Alfred the Lord Tennyson in the bathroom.
Well, at least the poet's been installed then.
What is it, a Swinburne, Shelley?
No, it's a Wordsworth.
Oh, bloody daffodil.
Beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze.
Oh, forget it! Oh. What's your name, dear?
Varnish.
No, your first name, silly.
Wombat.
Oh, Wombat. Wombat Varnish. Take me to the place where eternity knows no bounds, where the garden of love encloses us round. Oh,
all right, I'll have a quick look at your Thomas Hardy.
Nude man, what did you make of that?
Well, don't you see? That was exactly the kind of explicit sexual reference I'm objecting to. It is titillation for the sake of it. A deliberate attempt at cheap sensationalism. I don't care what the so-called avant-garde left-wing intellectual namby-pambies say. It is filth!
Bishop.
Okay, don't let anybody lose!
The BBC would like to apologise for the constant repetition in the show. The BBC would like to apologise for the constant repetition in the show.
Right! Lunar module calling Buzz Aldrin, come in!
Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean that much.
The BBC would like to apologise to the police about the character of Police Constable Pan Am. He was not meant to represent the average police officer. Similarly, the reference to Buzz Aldrin, the astronaut, was the product of a disordered mind and should not be construed as having any other significance.
Hello, good evening, and welcome to Blackmail. And to start tonight's programme, we go north to Preston in Lancashire and Mrs. Betty Teal. Hello, Mrs. Teal. We'll be showing you more of that photograph later in the programme. Unless we hear from Charles or Michael.
Cutler, Staffordshire. Well, Mr. Chairman, it's just that most of the members in Staffordshire feel the whole thing's a bit silly.
Stupid English. See, our prisoners and all they do is the sport.
One thing worries me, Fitz.
Yeah?
There's a traditionally cheeky, unlovable Cockney sergeant.
Cheer up, Fritz! It may never happen.
My bits begone.
Good. Everything seems to be in order.
Hello, how are you? I'm fine. Welcome to a new half-hour chat show in which me, Viz the man what's talking to you now, and Brookie, to wit my flatmate, and nothing else, I'd like to emphasize that, discuss current affairs issues of burning import.
Have you heard the one about the three nuns in the nudist colony?
Shut up.
Over here, Sir William.
Sir William, over here.
Over here.
Now stay there.
Fetch me Smith Major.
Sir?
'Tis time you and your six brothers were married.
Thank you, Headmaster.
Fetch me your six brothers, that the seven brothers may be together.
I say, Teddy, you said something, Neddy. That's right, I did, Teddy. Well, what is it, Neddy? Piggy banks, Teddy. Piggy banks, Neddy.
This is Ken Clean Air System, the great white hope of the British boxing world.
The great thing about Ken is that he's almost totally stupid.
Basically, Ken is a very gentle, home-loving person. I remember when one of his stick insects had a knee infection, he stayed up all night rubbing it with germaline and banging its head on the table.
Oh, such a pretty baby. You're so kind and gentle. Really considerate to his mother.
We asked his sparring partner and one-time childhood sweetheart, Maureen Spencer.
Well, I think that if Ken keeps his right up, gets in with the left jab and takes the fight to his man, well, he should go for a cut eye in the third and put Wilcox on the canvas by six.
Ken's opponent in Tuesday's fight is Petula Wilcox, the Birmingham girl who was a shorthand typist before turning pro in 1968. She's keen on knitting and likes Cliff Richard records. How does she rate her chances against Ken?
Well, I'm a southpaw, and I think this will confuse him, particularly with his brain problem.
Oh, now he's gone. But he left a message. Dad, where's that note that fella left?
Oh. Here we are.
Evening, everybody. My name's Bradshaw, Inspector Elizabeth Bradshaw of the Special Branch Speech Day Squad. I'd like you all to think of me as the Bishop of East Anglia. And I'd like to present the first prize, the Jim Wade Grim.
Now, the first prize is the Granville Cup for French Unseen Translation, and it goes to Forbes Minor. Forbes Minor, right? Again, covering fire. Come on, Forbes. Come on, boy. Come on, get it out. Keep down. Well done, old man. The next prize.
Mr. L.F. Dibley's latest film, If. The studio tonight, Lord Portman, Chairman of the Committee, Sir Charles Avery, Employers Reorganisation Council, and Ray Millichoke, leader of the Allied Technicians Union. And they're going to make a human pyramid. Now we turn to the lighter subject of sport. And Reg Harris, the former world cycling sprint champion, talks to us about the psychological problems of big race preparation. But to close our programme, Dame Irene Stoat, who celebrates her 85th birthday this month, reads one of her most famous poems.
Who shall declare this good, that ill?
Michael, you tell me.
Are you Mr. and Mrs. Pete Forbes of 7 the Studios, L Street?
Yes.
Right, well, get in the car with one of you in the police raffle.
Gosh, David Blanks, the one and only, super to see you. Who are you working for? Come and work for me, I'll call you tomorrow. Hi, Alan, we must get together again soon. See you. We so nice having this little chat.
Well, actually, Timmy, I'm glad to get one.
You don't mind if Peter just sits in, do you?
Well, actually...
Only he's doing an article on me for the Mail. He's such a lovely person.
Hello.
Peter, this is one of the nicest people in the world, Nigel Watt. W-A-double-T, that's right, yes.
Actually, Timmy, the thing is, it's a bit private.
Oh, you don't mind if Peter just sits in, do you? Only Peter's writing a book on me. Peter, you know Tony from the Mail, don't
we?
Yes,
we met the Express. Yes,
sir. Soon, Percy.
I'm a bit embarrassed.
Sir Williams, it's so nice to see you. Will you sign this, my little daughter, please?
Hello, Mario. Super wonderful. Just two lovely coffees, please. Bye!
Timmy Williams, Cookies Island, brought to you live from What Is in Hobart.